Hello and welcome to Amazing Aircraft. What if I told you that the Soviet Union had a secret bomber that could fly faster than any fighter jet in the world? Would you believe me? Well, it's true. The bomber was called the Sukhoi T-4, also known as the Sotka or the Su-100, and the Soviets attempted to create a high-speed reconnaissance and strategic bomber aircraft, similar to the American XB-70 Valkyrie. In this video, I will show you how the T-4 was a remarkable but doomed project that pushed the boundaries of aviation technology in the Cold War era. So, are you ready to dive into its story? Then buckle up and let's go. The T-4 was a response to the Cold War challenge posed by the United States, which had developed several advanced aircraft and missile systems that threatened Soviet security and interests. The U.S. had deployed nuclear missiles in Italy and Turkey, flown spy planes over Soviet territory, and developed the supersonic bomber, XB-70 Valkyrie, which could fly at Mach 3 and carry nuclear weapons. To counter these threats, the Soviet government held a request for proposals among the aircraft design bureaus in 1963, aiming to develop an aircraft analogous to the XB-70 Valkyrie. The plane had to be able to fly at Mach 3, carry a payload of 10 tons, and have a range of 7,000 kilometers. The Sukhoi design, led by Pavel Sukhoi and Naum Chernyukov, was favored over the designs submitted by Yakovlev and Tupolev. After a preliminary design review in June 1964, the building of a prototype was authorized. The project was given the highest priority and secrecy and was supervised by the Ministry of Aviation Industry. The T-4 was a delta-winged aircraft with a slender fuselage and four turbojet engines mounted under the wings. It had variable geometry air intakes that could adjust to different speeds and altitudes. It had a droop nose that lowered to provide visibility during takeoff and landing. The aircraft was made of titanium alloy, which could withstand the high temperatures generated by the friction of the air at Mach 3. The T-4 had a length of 44 meters, a wingspan of 22.6 meters, a height of 9.8 meters, and a weight of 115 tons. It could fly at a maximum speed of 3,200 kilometers per hour at an altitude of 25,000 meters. It could carry a payload of 10 tons, including bombs, missiles, or reconnaissance equipment. The T-4's design was similar to the XB-70 in terms of speed, range, and payload, but it was smaller, lighter, and more maneuverable. It also had a better radar cross-section, making it less detectable by the enemy. However, the T-4 was more expensive and complex to build and operate and required more advanced technologies and materials. The development of the T-4 required massive research efforts to overcome the technical challenges of Mach 3 flight. Nearly 600 patents or inventions are attributed to the program, including new manufacturing technologies, heat-resistant materials, aerodynamics, navigation systems, and flight control systems. The T-4 was also equipped with a sophisticated electronic warfare system, which could jam or deceive enemy radars and missiles. The first flying prototype of the T-4, designated 101, was completed in the autumn of 1971. The test pilot was Vladimir Ilyushin, son of famed aircraft designer Sergei Ilyushin, and the navigator was Nikolai Alfyorov. The T-4 made its maiden flight on the 22nd of August 1972 from Zhukovsky Airfield near Moscow. The flight lasted 37 minutes and reached a speed of 1,500 kilometers per hour and an altitude of 12,000 meters. The T-4 flew only 10 times for a total of 10 hours and 20 minutes until the 19th of January 1974. The T-4 never reached its design speed of Mach 3 due to technical problems and political interference. The T-4 project was canceled in 1975 for several reasons. The Soviet leadership changed after Brezhnev's death in 1972, and the new leaders were less supportive of the project. The U.S. canceled the XB-70 program in 1969 and signed the Anti-Ballistic Missile Treaty with the Soviet Union in 1972, which reduced the need for a high-speed bomber. Additionally, the development of MIRV systems made the bomber less relevant. Lastly, the T-4 project's cost and complexity exceeded the resources of the Soviet aviation industry. The T-4 was a remarkable achievement of Soviet engineering and innovation, but it was also a victim of many technical challenges that delayed its development and testing. One of the main problems that the T-4 faced was the engine performance. The T-4 used four Kolesov RD-3641 engines initially designed for the Tu-144 supersonic airliner. These engines were powerful but also very thirsty and noisy. They consumed a lot of fuel, which limited the aircraft's range and endurance. They also produced a lot of noise and vibration, which affected the crew's comfort and safety. To solve these problems, Sukhoi tried to develop a new engine, called the NK-321, which was more efficient and reliable. However, this engine was not ready until the early 1980s, and it was too late to be installed on the T-4. Another problem that the T-4 faced was the fuel consumption. The T-4 had a large fuel capacity, but it also burned much fuel at high speeds and altitudes. To save fuel, the T-4 had to fly at subsonic speeds for most of its mission and only accelerate to supersonic speeds for short periods. This reduced the aircraft's effectiveness and survivability, as it made it more vulnerable to enemy interceptors and missiles. To solve this problem, Sukhoi tried to improve the aerodynamics and weight of the T-4 by using a variable sweep wing, a retractable roomer, and a lighter airframe. However, these modifications also increased the aircraft's complexity and cost. Another problem that the T-4 faced was stability and landing. The T-4 had a very high landing speed, requiring a long runway and a powerful braking system. It also had a very low stability margin, making it difficult to control and maneuver. The T-4 had a fly-by-wire system that was supposed to compensate for the instability. Still, it could have been more reliable and often malfunctioned. To solve this problem, Sukhoi tried to improve the flight control system and the landing gear of the T-4 by using a digital computer, a hydraulic booster, and a drag chute. However, these improvements also increased the aircraft's weight and maintenance. The T-4 project was initiated during the era of Leonid Brezhnev, who supported the project and allocated substantial resources, amounting to about 2 billion rubles, approximately $2.5 billion at the time. However, after Brezhnev's death in 1982, new Soviet leaders like Yuri Andropov and Mikhail Gorbachev were less supportive and favored more economical projects, like the Tu-160 designed by Andrei Tupolev. The Tu-160, similar to the T-4 in terms of speed, range, and payload, was cheaper and easier to build and operate. It also had a better weapon delivery system and more modern electronic warfare capabilities. First flown in 1981, the Tu-160 entered service in 1987 and remains the largest and heaviest combat aircraft ever built. The T-4 project was officially canceled in 1975 after only one prototype was built and tested. Although additional airframes were planned, the project was suspended in 1974 and officially scrapped in December 1975. The 101 prototype was sent to the Central Air Force Museum in Monino for display. The 102 was used for ground tests and later dismantled, while 103 and 104 were never completed. 105 and 106 remained on the drawing board. The T-4 was a significant achievement of Soviet engineering and innovation, leading to nearly 600 patents and inventions in materials, aerodynamics, and avionics. These advancements influenced other Soviet aircraft designs like the MiG-25, MiG-31, and Tu-160. The MiG-25 Foxbat was a high-speed interceptor and reconnaissance aircraft, capable of flying at Mach 2.8 with a 24,400-meter service ceiling. The MiG-31 Foxhound was an improved version with better engines and avionics, capable of Mach 2.83 and equipped with phased array radar. Both aircraft were widely used by the Soviet and Russian air forces. The Tu-160 Blackjack remains the largest and heaviest combat aircraft, capable of Mach 2.05. It has a variable sweep wing, a droop nose, and a refueling probe, and it continues to undergo modernization and upgrades. The T-4 project was both a remarkable technical achievement and a doomed failure, never fulfilling its potential due to changing political and strategic circumstances. It was a visionary project ahead of its time, but ultimately left unfinished. It was the Sukhoi T-4, the Soviet Valkyrie. That's it for this video. What do you think of the T-4? Was it an achievement or a failure? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. The sky is just the beginning. See you next time!